In this video, I discuss about filter in fluid power system. Fluid power system means filter in a hydraulic systems as well as the filter in a pneumatic system. First, I explain the symbol of filters, then basic of filters, and discuss about the various types of the filters by using their diagrams in the detail. So first we study the symbol. So when we drawing the hydraulic circuit as well as the pneumatic circuits, we need to draw the symbol of various component. Okay, so how the filter is drawn? So filter is drawn by using the Drees type of the symbol. Here you see that is a diamond square. Inside this diamond square, it is the dash line, and this is the inlet line, and this is the outlet line. Okay, in some case it is also drawn by using this type of the line. So here, compared to the first one, here one horizontal line is added. Dust in a working fluids create a lots of problems in the system. Suppose the dust is enter in a hydraulic system with the oil. Suppose dust is enter in a pneumatic system with the air. Okay, so this create the lots of problems. Okay. So our human body is also feeling the problem related to the dust. Okay, when the dusty environment, so we are feeling the lots of problems. Okay, or we are not feeling the comfortables because we are inhaled air. Okay, so similarly pneumatic systems are inhaling the air for their workings, and in a hydraulic systems instance of that they use the oil. Okay, so it's increase the frictions between the moving parts, hence there will be a wear and tear of the parts and the loss of energy in a form of heat. Suppose we are not filtered the air or the oil and directly supplied to the system. Okay, so this dust particle is enter in a moving component, either it is the reciprocating or a rotary component. Okay, and they are stick with the surface. Okay, and they are stick with the surface and they are increase the wear and tear, and finally due to the wear and tear there is a loss of energy in a form of heat is increased, and the component is early wear out, so we need to replace the components. Okay, similarly way, suppose you riding the two wheel or four wheels. In a two wheel that is a air filter is not used, but in a four wheel, okay, they are used the air filters. So after the sometimes we need to change the air filter. Okay, the dust also able to form the vanish and gel and chalk up the parts and vents in the system. Vent means it is a different pipe in the systems. Okay, so this dust are also able to create the gel and vanish, which are chalk up the various pipe connections in the hydraulic systems, which create the disturbance to the flow of the fluid. It increase the rate of oxidation of working fluids and it corrode the metallic surface. The trouble due to the dust in the working fluids are countless. Hence, dust has to be removed first and the clean the working fluids shall be supplied to the system. Okay, so there is a number of problem is created due to the dust. That's why first we need to remove the dust by using the filters, and then we supply in a fluid power system, means hydraulic system as well as the pneumatic system. Now here we study the classification of the filters. So filters are classified according to the two category. First category is according to the function. According to the function, first is the surface type, second one is the edge type, and third one is the depth type. Okay, so be connected with this video. After classification we study this filter in the detail. Second one is the classifications according to the construction. First one is the bypass type filter. Second one is the full flow filter. Third one is the proportional flow filter. And the fourth one is the indicator type filters. Now before moving ahead, I request to like my video and subscribe my channels for watching the more video related to oil, hydraulics and pneumatics. For more video, the link is provided in description as well as from the card. Card means on the top right screen of your laptop or mobile you see the eye symbols. So in a card various link is provided, or for more subject I request to visit the playlist. Now first one is the surface type filters. So this is also called as the screen filters. In a surface type filter, the solid impurities are screened and retained on the surface of the filters. Okay, so in this, according to the functions at the which place the dust are collected. Okay, so every filters there is a some basic component. Here in this image you saw it is the inlet. Okay, here some inlet pipe is there, then it is coming a inlet. So this field is caching, and here you see it is a filter element. Okay, so that is a various type of the filter element is used. Okay, and after the filter, it is moved to the outlet port and then finally supplied that to the outlet parts. Okay, and here the drain plug is generally used to empty the filters. So in a surface type, depth type, and the edge type, so where the dust are collected on the basis of they are classified. Okay, so here you see the filter. So filter element is different type, and on the which side of the filter elements dust are collected, according to that its name is given. So filter element are the masses of metal wires, woven cloths of metal wires and yarn. So this filter element here you see are constructed from the masses of metal wires, means it look like as the strainer. Either it is used for the woven cloths of the metal wires. So wire masses of different size are used. Different size means that is a gap between the wires are smaller, larger, depending upon the system. So these filters can be cleaned and reused. So why its name is surface type? Because it is collected on the surface of the wire. That's why this name is given the surface type filters. Next one is the edge type filter. So in this type of the filter, the solid impurities are trapped at the edges of the plate, which are arranged parallel to the each other with negligible clearance between them. Okay. In a first case, what we use the masses of metal wires. It's look like as the strainers. Here, what we use, we are using the plate, and on the surface of the plate edge of the plates, okay, we collect the impurities. That's why its name is given to the edge type filters. Here, it is connected on the surface of the wires. That's why it is called as the surface type filters. So here, this image is same as the earlier case, but this filter element is changed. Okay, here wire mesh is used. Here the plate is used. So different type are that in a edge type filters. So as a filter element, we have a different option. Either we use the disc type, either we use the ribbon types, or either we use the plate type. And these filters can be cleaned and reused. Disc type means it is the cylindrical component is used. It is called as the disc type. And the plate means plate may be rectangle, square, any shape of the plate can be used. This type filter is rated at 98% removal of particles from 40 to 125 microns, and in a ribbon type filters, the dust is removed from 25 to 500 microns. So here you see the range of the disc type and the ribbon type filters. So ribbon type filter is remove the more size, okay, up to the 500 micron, and in a lower side it is at 25. In a disc type, lower side is 40 and upper side is the 125 microns. Now next one is the depth type filters. So in a depth type filters, the solid impurities enter into the filter element to a certain depth and the trap there. Okay, here you see this is the inlet, and here you see this filter element design is changed. Okay, here it is, you see that is a depth type, and inside that you indicate the different depth, because it is made from the different types of the powders, and these impurities are trapped at a certain depth of the trap there. Okay, so in a certain depth they are trapped, and this is the outlet part. So these filter elements are made of the material such as the sinter metal powders, sinter ceramic powders, and natural synthetic fibers, yarn and cotton. So filter element of sinter powders can be cleaned to extends by the back washings. So filter elements of the sinter powders can be clean extends by the back washings. So if we wash that, they are easily reused again. But another type which are mentioned above cannot be reused. Okay, here me use, but it is reused. Okay, so out of this, we are only able to use the sinter powder type elements are the reusables, other are not able to reuse. Now next one is the bypass type filters. Okay, from the bypass, what you understand? So you already hear about the bypass heart surgery. Okay, in bypass heart surgery, what the doctor is doing, one vein of the heart is blockage which supply the blood to the hearts. Okay, then doctor is give the bypass connections to the these veins. Okay, so they take another veins and the putting that, suppose here the blockage is created. Okay, so doctor is connect this inlet and outlet by using this another pipe. Okay, suppose this is the blockage, So this inlet and outlet is connect by the another vent, means bypass is given. Okay, sometime you go on some roads and there is a bypass road is provided because there is some work is going on the particular road, so they provide the bypass. Okay, so it is called as the bypass type filter. So similar way in a bypass type filters, so in a bypass filter is a filter which bypass the fluid from the filter element. It allow the fluid to flow directly without filtering whenever the filter elements get the choker completely. So here you see, this is the inlet port, this is filter element, this is drain plugs, and this is the outlet. Okay, in between the inlet and outlet, here you see one valve is provided. Okay, so in certain case this filter element is completely choked, then we are not able to filter the oil. Okay, and this part is stock up, then the outlet from this filter is zero, so our hydraulic system is stopped. But we need to use the hydraulic systems, then we are use the bypass type filters. Suppose this system is choked, then we open this valve and the oil is directly supplied from inlet to outlet without filter. Okay, so it has a spring loaded check valve in between the inlet and outlet port. So this valve is the which type? It is the spring loaded check valve. It has a depth type filter elements. So here you see, this is a depth type filter elements. Okay, in earlier case we study already, that is a depth type filter. So this filter is used depth type, but in a depth type we here provide the check valve, that is a spring loaded check valves. In a depth type filters, the solid impurities enter into the filter elements to a certain depth and trap there. These filter elements are made of the material such as the sinter materials, powder, sinter ceramic powders, natural and synthetic fibers, yarn and cotton, that we already studied. Filter element of sinter powders can be cleaned to extents by the back washing, but another which are mentioned above cannot be reused. Now next we study the advantages of the bypass type filters. Whenever the filter element is choked up to a greater extent, this valve open to make the direct connections from inlet to outlet. That means our systems are not stopped in a bypass type filter is used. Thus it is safeguard the filter elements against the damage due to the high pressure difference. So when the choking is done, that is a high pressure is created at the inlet sides. Okay, so if the high pressure is created, that is the chances of the damage of the various parts of the fluid power systems. Now what is the disadvantages? So contaminated unfiltered fluid flow to the system when the filter element is completely choked up. Means when the filter is choked up, then contaminated fluid is supplied to the hydraulic systems, which increase the or which create the number of problems into the hydraulic systems. The filter element should be immediately replaced. Now next one is the full flow filters. From the name you can understand what is the meaning of full flow system. Okay, so for a full flow system we draw the image of the depth type filter. Okay, as the name implies that the full flow of the working fluid is the filters. Okay, means it is a completely fulls with the oil. Okay, or a air. If the hydraulic system is used, then it is filled with oil. If pneumatic system is there, it is filled with the air. The working fluid has to flow through the filter element completely. Why it is completely? Because it is the full flow filters, and the entire working fluid is filtered and clean working fluid is coming out of the filter. Next one is the proportional filters. Proportional, from the name of the proportional, what you understand? Some part is going the filters and some is directly go to the outlets. Okay, so in this image here you see, this is the inlet, then oil is enter here, enter in a filter elements. This is the outlet, but in between inlet and outlet, what you observe here, the venturi is provided. Okay, so now let's study about the proportional filters. In a proportional filters, portion of the working fluids only pass through the filter elements. Means some portions of the working fluid is supplied to the filter elements and some quantity of the working fluid is directly supplied to the outlet if the requirement is the higher. Rest of the volume of working fluid pass directly unfiltered through the venturi. Means here first sentence is what written? Proportion of working fluid only passes through the filters. And suppose here we supplied the 40% oil to the filter element, then 60% is directly supplied to the outlet and this passed to the venturi. So this is needed if the discharge through the filter element is less. Okay, it means if the discharge coming out of the filter is lower and we require a higher amount of the oil, then some quantity of the oil directly supplied through the venturi. So this is needed if discharge through the filter element is less. That is, the filter element is very fine and the systems need to more discharge. So thank you for watching this video. If you learned and liked the video, subscribe the channels and don't forget to share with your friend.